Hi, empath. Welcome, empath. I knew you would click on this video because it's made for you. Because the cat down the road told me you are absorbing people's negative energy. So, for defenseless empaths absorbing people's negative energy, watch this. Let me send you some good ass energy right about now. Take that, take that, take that. And to everyone who is watching this video, may increased wealth, health, love, peace, harmony, serenity, abundance pour into your life right about now. And it's going to. All you got to do is say two words. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Raising the frequency, raising the vibration. Beautiful deep divers, another marvelous day out here. There's no place I'd rather be than with the birds, bees, leaves, and trees. Breathe with me. Woo! Breathing in that good ass prana, baby. So, four. Defenseless empaths absorbing people's negative energy, start doing this. Watch this. Now, put your hand up if you are someone who is like a sponge person. You absorb people's energy. You can feel people's energy and it affects you every single day. Okay, you come to the right place because I'm also an intuitive empath, but over the years, I've had to learn how to protect my energy. And dear empaths, please protect your energy. Nothing is more important right now, especially in these days and times we're living in. So much is happening all around the world. Talk of war, Russia and Ukraine, it's affecting empaths. What they show on the news is affecting empaths. A pandemic, plandemic, COVID-19, it's affecting empaths. And right now, we have to really take real good care of ourselves, like coming into nature, doing a little samba, baby. That's what we have to do. Peace. Infinite waters, diving deep once again. Beautiful deep divers, we are out here in the heart of nature. It is so peaceful out here. I love nature. Now, are you a defenseless empath? Who is picking up other people's energies, absorbing all of their energies, and these energies are not serving you. In fact, they are bringing you down, weighing you down, overwhelming you. You don't know what to do, but you can't stop being who you are, and who you are is someone that cares a lot because you're an intuitive empath. You like put yourself in their shoes. You like feel it like they're feeling it. You are going through what they're going through. And now it's too much to bear, okay? For all of you empaths out there who are feeling defenseless, like you have no protection because of what's happening in the world and in your immediate environment, people you're interacting with, sometimes I know what it's like when you are absorbing people's negative energy, but the empath cycle goes like this. Even though sometimes you know it's negative energy, you just want to help people. But now, for the first time, dear empaths, you have to say, enough is enough. Can you do that? Can you do that? Fantastic. And we ain't even had breakfast yet. Can I get a hello there? Because many empaths have a hard time saying enough is enough. You will stay in the presence of someone who is not even serving you because you care for them. You still want to help them, even though you know their energy is toxic. Sometimes you might even watch the news, even though you know it's not helping you. It's full of negative energy. But because you have this care, you want to help everybody in the whole entire world. You want to save the world. You feel, you're sensitive. But sometimes you reach a point where you feel now defenseless. You have no armor, no protection. And I'm going to help you out. Let me share with you what's helped me along my journey. First and foremost, dear empaths, you have the right to change the channel. Change the channel. You don't have to see images of war. I know you care about what's happening in Russia and Ukraine, but you can turn it off. And you can come into nature and give yourself that self-care you need. Dear empaths, if you feel defenseless in absorbing other people's negative energy, you can say no. It is okay to say no. It is okay to cancel that commitment. It is okay to let people down. It is okay to not fulfill their wants and needs and their desires and do all of their favors they're asking you to do. It's okay. You're not a bad person for putting yourself first and loving yourself to say, actually, before I can help you, I've got to help me. I've got to protect my energy. And yes, you do. Because if you do not, you will go down with a sinking ship. Nothing is more important than you realizing this. Don't say yes to other people when it's a no to yourself. That was me. Growing up, I would just say yes to people. Yes, 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 yes. But it was a no to myself. And empaths struggle to say no because you don't want to let people down. Well, it's okay to let people down if you are protecting your energy in the process. What? Slow motion this side. That was said in Feel Alive. Go and check out that new book, Feel Alive by Ralph Smart on Amazon and at ralphsmart.com/the book. Also, shout out to everyone who's been getting the wonderful Good Ass Prana shirts at ralphsmart.com/clothes and spreadshirt.com if you're in America. So, it is okay to let people down if you are protecting your energy. It is okay to say no to other people if you are protecting your energy. It is okay to turn off the TV if it's helping you protect your energy. It is okay to leave a crowd and spend time with yourself if it is protecting your energy. Dear empaths, for you empaths feeling defenseless in absorbing people's negative energy, remind yourself, you didn't come here to be a background character in other people's lives. And you definitely didn't come here to be a background character in your own life. Because you are important. You are player one of this life. You did not come here to be a background character in your own life. And a lot of empaths are. They are background characters in their own life. They are passerbyers in their own life. They are spectators in their own life. And this is how you start absorbing this negative energy. No, stop being a background character and say, actually, I'm a real human being and I matter. And I'm not going to tolerate being around shoddy energy. Because I'm worth more than that. Carry yourself like a king, like a queen, like the crown jewels and say, actually, I have to recharge, replenish, rejuvenate, detox. And this is how you really stop absorbing people's negative energy. Learn also to have a cutoff point. If you are talking to someone and you feel drained, if you are around a lot of people and you're picking up negative energy, say, right now I'm drawing the line. I'm setting healthy energetic boundaries. And I'm empowering myself by realizing I am responsible for accepting the invitation. I am responsible for accepting the invitation. Because nobody can steal your energy without your permission. Nobody can drain your energy without your permission. You choose at all times. And if you don't like the vibes of certain people, environments, you can choose to not be there. You can actually say, I'm not going to accept that invitation. Thank you very much. I'm going to chill with the cat down the road and Ralph Smart. Do a little samba, baby. Nobody is forcing you to be there. I know as empaths, you feel like, gosh, if you let people down, you're a bad person. No, I want to remind you, you are enough. You do enough and you have enough. You're not a bad person for spending time with yourself and recharging yourself. Because for you defenseless empaths, absorbing people's negative energy, listen to this. You have a right to realize you are not under obligation to save the world, to save humanity, to save other people before yourself. No, you are here to save yourself first. How can you help other people if you aren't helping? How can you help other people if you can't even help yourself? Charity starts at home. And this is the reason why being an intuitive empath is a great gift, but you have to learn how to protect your energy. You have to learn how to protect your energy. And you do this by saying, okay, I have a gift of caring, of putting myself in other people's shoes, but am I really there yet to give that energy to other people? You see, you deserve the energy you so freely give to other people. Slow motion this side. And when you learn to work on yourself, work on your emotions, recharge, have that alone time to really get back your energy, you can now be selective with who you share your energy with. And this is how to stop absorbing people's negative energy. Remind yourself as well that things are not happening to you, they are happening for you. If you are around people and they're giving off negative vibes, remind yourself this is also helping you evolve. You're now seeing your threshold level. And you have to honor that threshold level to say, actually, this is enough for me. Right now, I need to not be around that kind of energy. You don't have to throw yourself into the storm 24/7, empaths. You can say, actually, I'm not going to fight in this war. I'm going to protect my energy. For defenseless empaths, absorbing people's negative energy, remind yourself of this. Stop seeking external validation. Many empaths are trying to be nice. Nice is the old English. It means stupid. You didn't come here to be nice. You came here to keep it real. And when you learn every single day, you have the right to express yourself. You got the right to do that. Raising the frequency. You got the right to express yourself as you see fit. You've got the right to show the world and tell the world how you are feeling. You've got the right to be vulnerable. You've got the right to say, actually, my feelings matter. Because many empaths don't think like that. They think everybody else's problems are more important than their own. Everybody else's feelings are more important than their own. Nothing could be further from the truth. Dear empaths, your feelings matter. Your feelings are valid. Please protect your energy and realize that you have a gift. In ancient times, the empaths were the healers, and they still are. But before you can become a healer, you have to work on yourself. You have to see that this gift of sensitivity is not a curse. It's a superpower. Slow motion this side. But this superpower that you have to care for other people who aren't even around you takes great responsibility, and it takes great mastery to really make it work for you. As an empath, what do I do when I'm around negative vibes from people or the world in general. I say, okay, right now, I have to remind myself I'm not a victim of circumstance. I'm a co-creator of my own reality. Empaths, remind yourself, life is never happening to you. It's responding to you. And if you can learn every single day, I have this exercise, okay? For defenseless empaths, absorbing negative people's energy. It goes like this. As an intuitive empath, as an empath, you place yourself in other people's shoes. So if someone is crying, very sad, you now feel sad as well. But this actually affects your energy in a negative way. So what you have to learn to do is say, what is the most empowering emotion I can feel right now that can help the other person? And more times than not, it's when you are in a higher frequency and vibration. If people are sad and afraid, if you drop to their frequency, now is both of you. But if you raise your frequency, not only do you help them, but you now help yourself. What? Slow motion this side. Empaths always want to help the world. And that's beautiful. I was listening to Michael Jackson's song, The Earth Song. Phenomenal song. And that's what an empath does. Like, you sing for the world. And right now, the world needs love. Right, Deep Divers? Right. But empaths, to stop absorbing people's negative energy, remind yourself, stop focusing on what you cannot control outside of you. Like, the news shows us, it's always bad news and it's negative images, people dying, bombs dropping, COVID, all of this stuff. And you're picking up that energy. Or if you're going around busy, polluted cities, you are absorbing people's stress, their chaos. They just had an argument with their partner last night. You're absorbing all of these thought forms, right? So what you want to do is really, once again, change the channel and realize that focused on what you can control. I call it the immediate environment, the immediate environment. And when you say, okay, who can I help right now? Because as an empath, you want to help people. You want to heal people. So you say, I can still do this. Who's in my local community that needs help or care? Because this is more empowering. Now you can actually help someone who needs it instead of being shown images of people thousands of miles away and you feeling disempowered because you cannot do anything. So focus on what you can change and not on what you cannot change. And also, for defenseless empaths absorbing people's negative energy, know your role as an empath. Your role as an empath is the role of a healer. And there's something called the wounded healer. But before you can heal anyone, you must heal yourself mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually. And that takes you going on the journey within. It takes you spending time with yourself, getting to know yourself, and knowing how to use this great gift of empathy. How did I do it? I turned my empathy into inspiring millions of people. What? Slow motion this side. And that's why I just say, feels so good to be alive, baby. Can I get a hello? Beautiful deep divers. I'm just... Woo! Breathing in that good ass prana, baby. I love all of you. Peace. Infinite waters, diving deep once again. Stay well. Stay healthy. Peace. Yo! Leave a comment down below of love and appreciation and empaths. Let me know how you are empowering yourself today. Oh, you want me to go live on this topic? Just say, go live, Ralph. Peace.